hey guys, I really miss you. We're gonna do a little Tabata today to keep your workouts going while you're away. It's gonna be 30 seconds on, 10 seconds off. We're gonna start with the right side for a side lunge. I got 19 more seconds, so it's gonna start, and then we're gonna move to our left side after our 10 second break. Right side starts, right lunge, and go. So you can bring your leg all the way up, or if you feel a little off balance, you can just step. Break. And relax. It's actually a 15 second break. At home, you can do it however you want. 5 seconds. And our left side. Again, you can just bring your foot forward to the side. You may even get a little tired and want to do it this way. And 15 second break. We're going to do it 3 times, so we're going to go back to the other side. Okay, so two, if you get a little bit tired, just go to your step and work a little slower, which I like better for the fact that I like to work through the movement rather than speed it up and short myself. So we're going on to our third set. Anyone who knows me knows I hate to be in front of a camera and I hate cardio. So this is really fun for me, but it'll be a good workout. Good. So next we'll go on to our reverse lunge kick. Reverse lunges are better for the back end. balanced on, this tends to be mine. So if you don't want to do the kick, you don't have to do the kick. I'll do a couple without and show you what to do. So back lunge and step and step. This is good if you're feeling off balance, you're getting a little winded. Good things to think about, keeping your abs pulled in tight, squeeze your bum. And last one, on your right side. Break. Moving on to our squat knee. Squat, knee. So this is a big one not to rush. Go low in that squat. Think about what I said earlier, pulling in your abs, squeezing your bum, makes it extremely hard. Wanting to go to the other side. It's obviously my dominant side. these are leading into being on the floor and working our abs completely. And go. Starting to feel my legs now. Oh, I gotta go that side, right? Abs pulled in. Try to squeeze. And rest. Set coming up. And go. So a modification here would be just squatting. Squat, tap, squat, tap, or regular. And break. There you go. Last one. Oh, shoot. Again, just squat. Squat tap. And that is done. We are now going to the floor for our toe taps and crunches. Toe taps or heel taps, I keep saying toe taps, but heel taps are here. So after we finish our heels and we take our break, we'll go to our crunches. Crunch, not a full sit up. Hands behind head. And go. If you want to put your hands in front, if you feel better that way, that's fine. Just pull your abs in. And break. Good. So now back to our heel taps. Again, heel taps, I like to slide across my body because I feel like I get a better connection in my oblique right up top here rather than really out far. Some people like that better. I like the sliding motion. Pull your abs in really tight on these. And you'll feel it all the way from the upper to the lower punches on your head. Your chin should really always be tucked when you're doing the crunch. And go. Take a break. Again, I'm not a speed demon on these. I like to work through the muscle and I like to contract it really hard so I can feel that muscle working. And go, our toe taps. We do three sets of these, so we're on our second. Almost done with the workout. Quick and easy. Maybe not so easy. And take a break. To finish. Pull your abs in real tight.